biggest upgrade we've had in the Gutenberg blocks is actually the navigation block. Now, with Gutenberg working so hard to have a front-end editing, we see that the navigator, which is placed in the layout elements, is one of those blocks that will allow us to basically have your whole editing of the page right here in the editor. So when you choose to create from all the top pages, you have this available for you. Now, of course, you can add other URLs, links. Let's say if I wanted to add a Google link to this, I am able to just paste it out, and you actually see it's very intuitive. When you add a page and you're online, it actually picks that up and then it will add the information that you need. So for example, this I added as Google, but I can actually click enter to actually just change the URL, and I can click this just to see where it's leading me. Once you create links like this one, and we add another one, let's say we're going to do AOL for America Online, we're able to move them across the board and have maybe this just going to the far right. And so we'll have all of this starting up. You have the option of adding submenus here. So I'm going to add this as a home page. And then I'm going to, of course, add another. I don't want to go an extra layer deep, but I'm going to have, let's say this is going to the contacts page. And you can see this is already going layers deep, but I don't want it to be layers deep. After adding a couple of links here, I'm just going to save this and update, and then I'm going to go back to our page, refresh it, and then see how this looks like on the front end. So we have our menu here, and you can see from here that it has a link down. This is going to really change the way we view WordPress, or how we use it, in that we'll have the opportunity to do all our editing right inside here. So there is no need for us to actually build a navigation outside this. So you just get this. Let's say you've created everything that you need, and now you're removing these other links that shouldn't be there. So I can remove that. Come here, remove block. It makes sense for me. So I can add a hello. It's going to find for me the link post, so I can add the link post there, which is a submenu of this. I can add another item and say this is going to go to yahoo.com, and as I add that, that will be URL. So you actually see they are on the same level. I can say maybe this is going to greenland.com, assuming that is an available link. So if we update here, come back, reload. Yep, we have our sub menu on our menu inside our content. So that's what the navigation block does for you. So please check this out, enjoy it. Let me know in the comments what you would like to know more about this. But while we're still here, you can actually see that these different links, as you put them here, you have a title attribute. So I'm able to change this and say chocolates. So this is going to go to chocolates. We can add a description and say link to chocolate channel. And maybe this is our channel for YouTube and we want to have it on chocolates. We need to add a nofollow link to it. And then of course you can add CSS through the additional classes. So when we update this, we'll come back here, reload, and not to get you off guard, actually have that information here. So when you right click here and you see this, you'll see that it has a title of chocolates. If you just hold your mouse over, you'll see it's called chocolates, and that's what we were looking for when we added this title attribute. So that's how we had navigation to our content. This is the way Gutenberg is handling content now. And as we head towards having front page editing, This will be very key for end users and people who create content, because it will allow them to do their menus right here without having to go into appearance. Then they go to menus and created, they are able to create just a simple menu in one page. And actually, what happens is, if I go to my homepage here, you realize this is only in the content of this page. If I go to another place, I will not be able to see that. If I go, let's say, to the sample page, in my content, you don't see that menu. So the navigation is only stuck to where you want it to be. So the one way we can use this over and over and over again is we can make this into what we call a reusable block. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select all these items and add them to the block. So we have the whole navigation block, which I really messed up. It has an option for selecting it to make it full width, or you can leave it as wide width to stay in the middle. We can actually see how we have leveled up, and we can even add more levels of content here, which you can edit, and which you can edit, or you can even remove and just keep it as simple as it was. So I'm going to select the whole block here. I cannot change it so much. We can actually make it into a dark style, or we can leave it as light, or we can even change the text color and say we're going to apply the text colors that come from the palette that we have provided. And so we can even use a custom color here. So let's go for something that is a bit brown. So that's the color we want. This is the color of our navigation. If I get the whole navigation, we can add a different style to it. Let's say if we want it to be dark, we can add an anchor text to it so that we can link from any part of the website and just link to this particular section of our page. Of course, we can add additional style sheets through custom classes of CSS, and I'm going to make this into a reusable block, and I'll call this my nav. Okay, so once I save this, it means I can just replicate this anywhere in the pages that I do have. So I'm going to come to the sample page here that comes by default in WordPress, and I am going to add that reusable block, and I can start by typing my, which is not coming, so I'll go for reusable. As I am typing reusable, you'll see the available reusable blocks that I have, and I remember saving it as my nav. And once I do that, I can update this here, and then we'll go to view page. And if we view page, we actually see we have the same navigation that we had in the other page. So this is how we use reusable block. They don't have to be navigation only. They can be paragraphs, they can be images, it can be a gallery, it can be a cover image. So we can save this and reuse it over and over and duplicate it over our pages without writing any other lines of code. We are just sticking to what we have here in our interface. So that's how you use reusable blocks. Now, I remember in an earlier video, I told you we would go to the reusable blocks manager. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click manage all. I'll just update this and leave it the way I did find it. So we're going to go to the manage all reusable blocks, and we'll see the reusable blocks that we have here, and we can export this all as JSON if we wanted to, and keep it somewhere, or copy it from one site and use it in another site by just importing this JSON. And we can also use this just to trash if we need to trash. And we can also use it, let's say, if we wanted to just edit, we can also edit the particular blocks that we have. So right now I click edit, and I can just edit this without all the other content coming in. So my space is actually clean, and I can just get this and add more links. Let's say I'm going to my blog, so I'll add a blog in there and then just hit enter, and then I'll just move these around and say I need the blog first, and then I'll bring the home page just before all the others. So I can move this to the right and move this also to the right, and once I'm done I'll update this. So if you look at this structure and look at what we had initially, I'm going to reload this page and you'll see that everything changes by me just editing the reusable block. So this is a perfect example for us to see how we can use navigation blocks and at the same time use them as reusable blocks in our content, in our page. Now, if I don't want this block here anymore, it doesn't have to stay there. All I need to do is come to the edit, select that block, and then just come to the options, remove it, move the block itself, update. On this page, we will not be having any other blocks here. But if we go to our content in our Hello World, you're going to find that we still have our block right here. So just because it's a reusable block, when you remove it from one area, it doesn't mean it's lost in another. So you can only use it only in the areas that you need to use it. So that's a wonderful feature that comes with a Gutenberg, and I am enjoying just using it. The best real life experience usage that you would have is maybe you have a media and text block, and you just add here your life size. Let's say this is your bio. So that's your picture, and then you talk about yourself and you say, I am a professional photographer. So if you are a professional photographer and you've added all the information you need to share with everyone else, you can just save this and say, I want to add it to my reusable block, and I'll just call it bio. So once I hit save, this is ready to be replicated on any page. Now, unfortunately, I've added this to my reusable block called nav, and if I update here and then come back and reload this page, you'll see that this automatically comes with the navigation all through the times. But if I don't need this in the nav, I'll remove it, update, I'll come back and reload here. The nav still sticks. But if I want to add this, if I want to add the other reusable block in any other part of my content, and we're going to add this at the bottom here. So we're going to add the reusable block bio. So when we add it there, we actually see that it's here. I'll update this. Let's go and see what it looks like on the front end. When I reload, you'll see that our bio is actually here. And the beauty of reusable blocks is actually seen. Thank you for watching this video. In the next video, we're going to be looking at the other blocks that are in the widgets section. I hope to see you then.